Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Cyber Gyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh and today we are going to discuss about the storage section, and under the storage we are going to discuss about EFS. It means Elastic File System, or you can call it Elastic File Storage. Fine. So what is it? How does it work? Let me show you the scenario first of all, that why do we use this and what is significant to use this. For example, if you are going to face any interview, so what happens is, for example, we have two servers here. This is my first server. This is my VM1. And I have another server. This is VM2. Fine. So what happens is, here I'm running HTTPD service. Fine. Over here also I'm running HTTPD service. These both servers are working under ELB, and on the top of ELB I have created one auto scaling group. Fine. So what happens is, if this machine faces some load, so it can go down and this auto scaling group will create this machine once again. If this machine goes down, so auto scaling will create this machine as well. It means we'll replace this machine with newly created machine. So what happens in that condition is, like if we have /var/HTML here, the same folder we have here /var/www/HTML we have here. So what happens is, all the data available inside this, same here, all the data available inside this, this data will be deleted, because by default the behavior of machine says that as and when any machine is going to get terminated, so the particular volumes are associated with this will by default gets deleted until unless you want explicitly that to be retained. But if you retain the volume, so only volume will be available, but you will not have that volume attached to your newly created machine automatically. Fine. So what you need to do is, you need to create such a volume, or you need to have such a mechanism which is known as EFS. It means Elastic File System. Elastic File System. Or you can call it storage as well. So what happens is, whenever you are going to mount this particular partition, it means var/www/html, so what you need to do is, you need to have EFS storage, and then you need to mount it on /var/www/html. Fine. So now what would happen is, so all the data which will be stored, for example, this is our EFS server. This is our EFS server. So all the data which will be stored here on this particular location, or maybe on this particular location, so that will be by default stored at some remote location that will be here. So if this machine goes down, so data is saved here. If this machine goes down, data is saved here. And if any new machine is created, so by default what we are going to do is, we can create one AMI, it means Amazon machine image, we can create, where we have already given the detail of this EFS within that AMI. So as soon as your new machine will be created, so by default that will contain all the data available here, and that machine will not lose even a single file. Reason being, because till that time this machine is serving, so all the images, or you can call like data or content, whatever that is, so all the stuff is kept here under var/www/html, and by default that is being stored at this particular location here. Fine. So this is how you can manage your data to be available all the times in high availability mode. And moreover, unlike EBS, it means Elastic Block Storage, one Elastic Block Storage could be mounted to one EC2 machine, wherein if you talk about EFS, so this can be mounted up to 1000, so maybe 2000 machines it can be mounted on. Fine. So how do we do this? How do we create this? Let us see. But before beginning for the practical of this topic, I would like, share and subscribe to my channel, and please do not forget to press bell icon, as you will be notified for my upcoming videos. So for this video, I have already created two machines. This is first machine and this is second machine. What I'm going to do is I will create a one common mount point here, where I will mount this EFS which I'm going to create, and after that I will show you that if I create a file with one server, so that will be available on another server automatically, because this is going to work like NFS. Fine. So let us see how to do that. Okay, so first of all, we have to understand that this is regional service. So we have to work on EFS. Let us click on EFS. Once we click on this, so we will be redirected, and we will be informed that EFS is available within how many regions. This is quite new service. It's been somewhere a couple of months only, like maybe 4 or 5 months it's been when EFS was launched. So this is new service, and I'm going to create this machine, this particular service in North Virginia. Although I am working in Mumbai, my servers are created in Mumbai, so I can create this particular service anywhere, wherever I want. Fine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two servers. First of all, I will create one EFS in North Virginia, and after that I will create two machines, maybe one in one A, then after one B. So I will do something like, and then after I will select security group by default. By default security group I will select there. Then after I will give the name. If I want to add text, so I'm going to say, I'm going to write here like web-EFS. So whatever name I want to give, I can. Okay, there's an interview question like, what happens if there's a problem with like latency? So you can go to maximum IO. It means that will definitely cost you a little bit high, but definitely there will be no latency problem. Then after, there is one more option which is known as bursting. It means we recommend bursting throughput mode for file system. You can use provision throughput mode for application that require more throughput than allowed by bursting throughput. So if you want really high throughput, you can go for bursting. You can decide like number of MB or number of GB you want per day, IOPS, and after that you can enable that. Then after, if you want to encrypt your data, you can encrypt this. For that you will have to create some encryption keys, but for this tutorial I'm not going to have. But yeah, for sure, if you want to have your data encrypted, which is going to be kept on your EFS, so you can enable that using this particular section. Now next, I will be asked that all the detail, whatever I have confirmed, AWS will ask me to review and create this particular. It means I'm going to create this file system for this VPC. Name is this, performance mode maximum IO, throughput bursting, and encryption no. So I'm going to create this file system. Okay, so in the meanwhile, I'm going to create two machines in the same region, in the same particular region, Mumbai. I'm going to create two EC2 machines where I'm going to mount this. So let me create two machines. It will take a while, maximum 2 minutes it will take to create two machines. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create two machines using default AMI, whatever is available here. But if you're going to keep this particular mechanism in your production environment, so keep this thing in mind that you should always have one AMI where this is pre-configured. I will tell you how to perform that activity, but before that let me create two instances. Okay, I will have to go back, reason being I wanted to create two instances wherein I have selected only one. Previous. Okay, here I'm going to create two instances. Okay, you can create instances one by one, and you can keep both the instances in different availability zone, but I'm going to keep only within one. I will have to select existing group, and that group will be default. And yeah, for sure I will have to edit this, because by default all ports range are allowed here. So review and launch, obviously I'm going to launch it, and let me create one new key pair here, and I will name it as EFS. Whatever I want I can give the name. So I have created two EC2 machines here. So let us go to EC2, and after that we will be able to see that two machines are created here. So I will log in using my dashboard, or you can call it like I will log into this machine using my Git bash shell, and after that I will have to perform all the activities which are required to mount your file system there. Let me make the size bigger for you guys. Okay, fine. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to log into this machine. This is North Virginia. Let me click on this, and obviously these two machines are running, so I will log into this machine one by one. Okay, I have copied this. I will go to downloads folder, and after that I will paste it. It will ask me for yes or no. Maybe it may not allow, reason being because by default North Virgin region and security group which I have configured does not allow this. So let me modify security groups. I'm going to click on inbound. By default nothing is allowed. So I'm going to say okay, allow port 22 from anywhere, and allow NFS as well. NFS, NFS, okay, let me search it here. Where is NFS? NFS, okay, yes. Why I'm going to allow NFS? Because your EFS works on NFS. Fine, so I'm going to allow anywhere. Yes, good, we are good to go with now. Now, if I click on this, and once again, if I press this, so it will ask me to say yes, and after that, I will log into this particular sudo hyphen I. That is it. I have logged into this machine. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste. Okay, I'm going to do the same activity for second machine. Let me go here. Two machines are running. So this time I will select this one, and I will perform same activity again. Just machine names are different. Rest of activities are going to be same because I am trying to log into both machines in the same manner. I will go to downloads first of all. Let me make it bigger a bit. Okay, then after I will paste it, and this will allow you to log into this machine because we have selected only default security group for you guys. So this is not best practice as I have done for this tutorial, reserving because you need to allow SSH from your own company IP or your own IP address, not from anywhere. Okay, fine. So now what we need to do is we need to go to EFS console where we have created. And if you go here, so you will get to know that how to mount Amazon EC2 mount instructions. It means if you click on this, you can open it in new tab, and it will show you that how to mount it. Instructions, how to mount. Okay, first of all, you need to do what is, you need to run this command, um install, and that is it. All the commands are given here, like NFS, Amazon, Amazon EFS utils. You will have to create this. After that, if you are using Amazon Linux instance, okay, sorry, I'm using Red Hat Linux, so I will have to install this one. So I will paste this command, yum install nfs-y, so all the packages are required will be installed. If you are going to use Ubuntu, so what you need to do is sudo apt-get install nfs common, because these are some different file names. Now I will have to create one mount point which is known as EFS, so I will create this one slash. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to place one slash here because I'm going to create it on root, and after that I will mount this one. I'm going to mount this one using NFS client, because obviously I'm going to use mount this particular as NFS client only. So what I need to do is I need to put a slash before here because I created this directory there only. Fine. So if I do the same thing here, so I will get to know the size is 9.3 exabyte. EFEBE means EB exabyte. Fine. So this is how we have mounted this. The same thing we are going to perform on second server. What we need to do is if we check the history, So what we need to do is sudo yum install nfsutils. So let us run the same command here. Okay, that is done. Let us copy second command. I have copied second command here, and I will paste it, the same command here, and it will take a while, and almost done. Yes, now I'm going to paste this command. So the same directory is created. After that, I will copy third command here, which is for mounting efs on slash. Okay, so done. I have run the same command here. So what I have done is I have mounted same file system at two places. So now if I go to efs, fine, and if I create any directory here, mkdirlokendra, fine. If I go inside Lokendra, so let me create some blank files here, touch, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on and so forth. We can create multiple files. And now let me go here on the server where I have not done anything. If I show you history, so I have not done anything here. If I go here on in slash efs, then after if I go to this directory Lokendra, so I will be able to see that multiple files are created here. I created on this server and files are available on this server too. Reason being because the files are created on a centralized location. That is common mount point. So what you need to do is you need to make these entries available within etc fs tab. How you can, you know very well, this is going to be part of Linux. So I'm going to tell you that how to do that. Df-th, first of all, you will have to write this, that what you are going to mount. So copy this one, go to etc and fs tab for permanent mounting. Okay, let me write vi, because vi is not installed here. Vi I'm going to write, I will click on paste. Okay, so what I'm going to mount, this particular partition, and where I'm going to mount slash efs. After that, what is file system? That is ext4, sorry, that is nfs4. And what are going to be our attributes for this? Default and 00. Fine. So I have done this. I will run mount hyphen a command. Done. Now df hyphen capital th. The capital T shows the file system type. Okay, so this is mounting in permanent mode. If you create AMI of this particular server at this particular moment, or if you have, okay, if you want to mount this on slash where www.html or wherever you want, so you can mount it at some different location as well, wherever you want to store your data. So this is somehow you can use EFS just to ensure that your data will be available across reboot, and if your machine gets terminated, though even your data will be available across reboot. So these are some interview questions so many people are asking nowadays, because obviously everyone is looking for high availability. Fine. So this is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good time. And yes, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe. And just to save your money, please remove all the sections, whatever you have created. Maybe you have created your EC2 machines, or you have created your this EFS. So you need to delete this for sure. If you don't delete, so you may have to face some unwanted incurring of amount or charges within your account. So thank you very much for watching. Have a good time. Happy learning. Thank you.